in Greece, to the northwest, near the Albanian border, perched on a peninsula surrounded by a lake, is the ancient picturesque city of Kastoria, home to fishermen, furriers, and merchants for more than 2,000 years, where a Jewish and Christian community had lit fires, broken bread, celebrated the grand holidays and small things of life together, where once 300 Sephardic families lived, danced, worshipped, milled flour, preserved food, laughed, cried, thrived. That all changed the day the snow turned black.
The snow came down black completely.
German, they're starting going to the houses and collecting all the Jews.
My grandfather, Nonofino, now I remember his words. I don't care. Let them take everything. Just they should leave me, my children, all of you.
Ακόμα θυμάμαι τις σκονιές αυτές. Είναι ζωηρινά που φώναζαν. Τι μπορούσε να κάνεις.
And by late afternoon, an announcement was made that anyone who wanted to move into a Jewish house could take over the house.
Out of 1,000 taken, only 35 survived. Through one family's eyes, we get a glimpse of every family's story. The story of the lost treasures of Kastoria.
Στις περιπέτειες του ξύδι, όλα τα χειμουνιάνι και τα ξύλα. Τα ξύλα θα έβαινες δυο φορές, θα έβαινες άνθρωπο μέσα στο σπίτι.
And my nono confino used to have a storage room. It was dark and was full of shelves. So he used to buy the best pears, the best apples, even melons, and arrange them on these shelves to get dry for the winter time. And they were proud, the grandfathers, to keep this place. They used to buy grapes and make wine in the house. Rati, feta cheese, yogurt. Used to make everything in the house. My mother used to tell me, you have to learn how to iron. You have to dust all the furniture and all the mirrors. It's your job.
Pemstrick.
The conditions were really awful. They used to take us, the house commando, to work in the fields. At that time, I used to work with cabbage. We used to grow cabbage and transfer it from one place to the other in small wagons.
Where was this?
Outside of Birkenau. And the Germans heard me that I used to sing. They used to look for me. And they used to call me, Griechenland, Griechenland, kommen Sie, kommen Sie. I used to sing for them, and they used to give me food. I saw in their faces, none of them were there. They wanted some kind of entertainment, some kind of relaxation. And they used to help me because I sang for them.
Who was that?
The Germans. They used to give me food every time that I used to sing for them, even candy.
We're going to stop this tape and continue on the next tape.
Somehow, we, I don't know how, one another, we found out when it was Yom Kippur. Even the piece of bread that we had to eat during the whole day, we saved it. We did not eat. And we pray. To be able to get out from here and tell the world what's happening. Because nobody, we could not even believe our own eyes. I don't understand how Germans, a culture country, an educated people, nation, how in the world could let be this Hitler, this crazy person to do all these awful things? And all the world was quiet. Why? Why this? Because we were born Jewish. We were children of God. Whether you are Jewish, Christian, black, white, yellow, Chinese, Mohammed, whatever you are, we are children of God. Why? I ask this, why?